In this tutorial, we'll cover how to add your company's Windows devices to your JumpCloud directory leveraging the JumpCloud agent. To get started, go to the Device Management tab in the menu on the left and select Devices. Navigate to the Devices tab, and here you'll see any existing devices. To add a new device, select the green plus button. JumpCloud is entirely vendor agnostic, meaning that we support Windows, Mac, Linux, iOS, and Android devices. For this use case, we're going to select Windows. If you're in a remote environment and you do not have access to the device, administrators can also provide end users the option to install the agent themselves through the user portal. There are several methods you can use to install the JumpCloud agent on Windows devices. You can install via MSI download, which is recommended for a manual device enrollment. You can install via PowerShell, which is recommended for a silent device enrollment, or you can create a provisioning package, which is recommended for light touch device provisioning. We're going to manually install the agent to a singular device by downloading the MSI file and running it. Select the Download MSI Installer button. You'll also see a connect key here. This connect key is a unique key that is required during install in order to add the new Windows device to your JumpCloud organization. Let's go ahead and copy the connect key. JumpCloud supports various Windows versions. To see a full list of JumpCloud agent compatibility, system requirements, and impacts, refer to the Help Center article by selecting Learn More. By installing the JumpCloud agent, you will have the ability to take over pre-existing local user accounts or provision new local user accounts within JumpCloud, thus enforcing a user's JumpCloud password on their Windows device and associated local Windows user account. For this demonstration, we'll be using a Windows VM with the hostname Stubbs Win Pro 11. This device has one local user account in Stubbs, and they are currently an administrator on the device. We'll go through the manual install along with binding the JumpCloud user to this Windows device, thus taking over the local account and enforcing the JumpCloud password. To get started, confirm you're logged into the device as the local administrator. Locate the jcagentmsisigned.msi file, then open it. In the installation wizard, on the destination location page, make sure it is set to C Program Files JumpCloud, and then select Install. Paste the JumpCloud device connect key that you copied when you download the agent, then select Next. If another application is using files that the installation needs access to, select Automatically Close the Applications or Manually Close the Application. Once the installation is complete, select Finish. This will install the agent and begin adding the device as a JumpCloud managed Windows device within your JumpCloud organization. This process can take a few minutes. Once the device appears within JumpCloud, the agent reaches out to JumpCloud in 60-second intervals. Any changes to the device, policies, commands, or bound user associations will be updated. Back in the admin portal, we can see the device has been successfully added. By clicking on the device, we can pull up some of the device's information, such as hostname, network adapter address, external IP address, agent version, serial numbers, and more. With System Insights, you can retrieve and report on even more data and information from the device. To take over the pre-existing local account, we need to bind the JumpCloud user account to this device. Navigate to the Users tab and bind the JumpCloud user by checking the checkbox next to their account. Please note that when binding JumpCloud users to JumpCloud devices, account takeover will only occur if the JumpCloud username or local user account are the same as the local Windows account. Otherwise, a new local Windows account is provisioned on the device. Before account takeover can fully occur on the Windows device, the JumpCloud user account must be in an active user status. You can also promote or demote a user's privileges as well during this process. Finally, save the configurations by clicking the Save Device button. The local user account is now using their JumpCloud credentials to access this Windows device. To learn more about adding Windows devices, check out our Help Center articles.